I'm Alan Martin, filling in for Frank Malicote, and welcome to Bay Sunday. Now, December 1st is World AIDS Day, and our next guest is being honored by the AIDS Emergency Fund, also known as AEF, at their sold-out gala. She's receiving a Lifetime Achievement Award for her fundraising work with HIV and AIDS. It also happens to be the 30th anniversary of her legendary disco hit, It's Raining Men. Take a look at this. That is great stuff. Please welcome the legendary voice of Two Tons of Fun and the Weather Girls, recording artist and honoree, Martha Wash, and also with us, the executive director of AEF, Mike Smith. Thank you both for being here today.
My pleasure.
I'm going to get to all of that stuff, but first, Mike, I want to talk to you about the Lifetime Achievement Award and how you picked her.
Oh, how could we not pick her? we have a very deep connection at AIDS Emergency Fund to Sylvester from his early, during his life, and we came to know Martha through that. When Sylvester was first diagnosed with AIDS, actually, in 83 and 84, he passed away in 1988. He and Martha and the Two Tons of Fun did all sorts of fundraisers all throughout the Bay Area, some of the very first people who were rallying around HIV and AIDS causes. And Martha's really had 30 years of giving and giving to the gay community and at Pride festivals all over the country and to HIV causes still. And 30 years, it's 30 years for AEF and it's 30 years for It's Raining Men. And we just thought, what better way to honor someone who's been with us for all this time?
Great timing, and it's well deserved. Okay, Mike mentioned it, Martha. You did sing backup for Sylvester, and he did leave his royalties, I guess, is what. Is that part of his legacy, leaving that to AEF?
I think it was a fabulous, fabulous idea. I don't think anybody's ever thought of anything like that. And it's astounding to me, but a wonderful, wonderful gift to them, I know.
It still helps our clients every day.
Well, and that's part of it, because I think there have been such advancements in prevention and treatment. People might assume, why do you need an emergency fund? Answer that one.
It's been a very good year in terms of HIV prevention work. We have great solutions that I think will slow and eventually stop the epidemic so that young people are less likely to become infected. But we're not hearing a lot about a cure for people who are living with HIV and AIDS, many who have been living 20 years or more on a very difficult drug regimen. Many of them are living in poverty. Many of them still need support. And they kind of fall off the radar as we focus more on the prevention side. We forget that there are people who still need help.
Right.
Well, Martha, tell us about the award, you know, what it means receiving it, and, you know, what the award is going to do as far as what you will do in the future for HIV/AIDS.
First of all, it's just an honor for someone to even think about me like that. A Lifetime Achievement Award, I still feel I have a lot more that I can do and contribute to this cause. It's definitely close to my heart.
Well, I know I want to get to the new album that you've released and all of that, because you haven't disappeared from the scene at all. But first, can we reminisce for a minute? What was it like, you know, back up for Sylvester?
It was fun for me. It was a learning experience. That was my first really professional job working with him.
About what age was that? You were young.
A baby.
It was a great opportunity.
I was just a baby.
Yeah.
No, I really was. I was myself and the lead guitarist. We were the youngest ones in his group.
Is that right?
Yes.
And so, how did that all come about?
I auditioned for him unknowingly. Quick story. I saw Sylvester 2 years prior to meeting him face to face. He was the opening act for Billy Preston, who I was a big fan of. Mm-hmm. They were doing a show at the Berkeley Community Theater. Went to go see Billy, saw Sylvester as the opening act, loved him, didn't know who he was, had never seen anything like him before. Fast forward 2 years later, I got a call to go do an audition, thinking I was going to audition for someone as a session singer, studio singer. Come to find out it was for Sylvester. And I auditioned for him and brought in Izora a few days later on, and the rest is history.
So which is better for you, performing live or getting into the studio and putting out say, this new album, the first one about 15 years?
Performing live, I would say. I don't think I'm a good studio recording singer, believe it or not.
What?
No, I that's...
Is that why it took 15 years?
That's the personal side for me.
Well, we are our own toughest
exactly,
critic.
Exactly.
Aren't we? Yeah.
It's like being in labor, you know, because this is...
I have no idea what that...
It's like being in labor. The finished product is your child, mm-hmm. you know, and sometimes it can be a long, tedious labor.
Okay, that that I understand, because I do have three children.
Okay.
And it never stops.
No.
You know, that never stops.
Exactly.
But the project does, and that's going to be released in January?
We're looking at January 10th.
Okay.
Called Something Good. That's the name of the CD.
I think we have a clip of that video as well. Can we go ahead and let's see that?
I'm walking on ice. I'm drawing the lines. I'm reading the signs. Oh, I've taken the world one war at a time. The fall and the climb. Oh, I make my own luck. I shuffle the cards. The spades with the heart. Oh, I'm taking a side. Not scared of the hide. I always turn right.
Something Good, that's I've Got You, the single, and your voice is incredible.
Thank you.
Your fans are going to eat this up. They're going to love it.
So. I hope they really do like this.
Well, you know what they're going to say? Please don't wait another 15 years.
I'll try not to.
You liked it enough that you'll do it. You'll do another.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Definitely.
And I think what people don't realize, too, sometimes is you had to do the studio work, but then the videos all come later. There's
yes.
a double project now. It's not
exactly.
It's like having twins.
There you go. Exactly. Yes.
To carry
that's,
on your analogy.
That's tedious too, but fun.
Yeah. Mike, back to the gala, and it's doing very well. Tickets are going, sales are doing very, very
We're sold
well.
Out.
And
We're sold out.
That's probably going
to
go.
It has a lot
great.
To do with this woman.
Yeah.
We're sold out because of Martha.
Tell me about the events and how it's come about over the years, and gotten bigger, I'm sure.
AIDS Emergency Fund started out with a few people around a kitchen table in 1982,
wow.
trying to figure out a way to pool their money so that friends wouldn't get evicted and had money to pay their rent when their landlords first discovered they had AIDS and tried to throw them out.
Mm-hmm.
Those few groups of people, a few events in bars, got us started. Today, we help about 2,000 people a year in San Francisco pay their rent, keep their lights on, cover their basic living expenses.
So if people can't get to the event, what can they do?
People can always help. They can go to AIDSEmergencyFund.com .org and make a donation to our cause. Every penny counts. We have a great program called Every Penny Counts that has penny jars on counters in bars and restaurants around the city. And we really do believe that literally every penny counts.
Now, Martha, are you going to stick around town? Are you off, where are you off to after this? What?
Go back to New York and get ready for the release of this CD.
All right. Well, we look forward to it.
Thank you.
Hope it tops the charts.
Yeah. Yes.
I'm sure it will. Well, congratulations on the award.
Thank you so
congratulations
much.
On the success of the event.
Thank you.
And we'll keep it going. We'll keep the awareness up.
Yes.
All right.
Yes.
All right. Thanks to both of you. Again, AEF Gala on World AIDS Day. It is sold out, so unless you already have a ticket, you can only see Martha Wash on Bay Sunday and CBSSF.com, but you can still get involved, as Mike said, with AEF. Log on to AEF-SF.org. Thanks for joining us.
I'm taking a side, not scared of the high.